Hi guys, this is Pashupati. In this video, we'll discuss about the control condition statement and control statement. So how can we write if condition in Python? So in Python, we'll be using if condition. We'll be using if keyword to achieve the if condition. Here we are going to tell, we are going to pass our condition. And here in Python, what happens, like we'll be using indentation to tell what is the starting point of the block and what is the end point of the block. You might have observed, like in other programming languages, we use curly braces to tell what is the starting block and what is the end block. In Python, we use indentation to identify this. So indentation is generally starts with colon, and followed by that, you will be writing your start block will start from the one tab space. And then here you are going to tell print 4 is greater than, and then else keyword will be used if you have to execute the second part. Again, the indentation will be telling, like, okay, from here it's going to start the second block, that is pi is greater than 4. So how do you tell that first block is over? The first block is going to start from here as soon as you start the indentation. So the next line, whatever you write, will be the tab space. And then we will say this belongs to true block. So if the condition is true, then it's going to come here. As soon as it sees the tab space is over, it assumes that that first block is getting over. And then again, you are starting the indentation here to tell what is the start block as soon as you give the tab space. And then here it's going to tell this belongs to false block, right? And then if you continue writing on the tab space, it will be part of the false block. If you want to end, you are going to start with the new line without tab space. Here will be this is not part of condition. You can see if my condition is true, it's going to execute the first block, that is 4, 6 is greater than 5. 4 is greater than 5, so you can see 4 is greater than 5. This belongs to true block, and this is not part of if condition. And similarly, if I tell that if 4 is greater than 5, which is the true condition, which is a false condition, it's going to come here and it's going to execute 5 is greater than 4, and this belongs to false block. This is not part of if condition. This is how you will be writing your if condition in Python. Let's talk about control statement. In Python, there are two types of control statement. The first one is for loop, second one is while loop. While loop can be declared in this way, like the while loop, if you have to use, I'll be declaring a variable and I'll be writing my condition, I is greater than, if I is greater than 5, again we have to tell what is the starting point of the while block. So I'll be using the indentation, and then I'm going to print I, and I'm going to increment the I value here. So what happens here, I have declared I variable to 0, and here I'm checking the condition. If I is less than 5, then enter the loop, print the value of I, increment the I value, and again check the condition. So let's run this and see what exactly it happens. So you can see it's printing the value till 4. Until unless this condition is satisfied, it's going to loop. Until unless the condition is satisfied, it's going to go into loop. Similar way we can write for for loop also. For loop is a bit different in Python. For loop will be using the range keyword to tell from where it has to start and where it has to end. And we'll be using indentation to tell the start and end point of the block. Your range is going to increment the value from starting with 0 till 5, and it is going to increment 1 by 1. So here we can see it's going to print, it's the range is going to return us the value from starting with 0, and it's going to increment 1 by 1 to I. If you want to print in reverse order, like in the reverse order 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, then we'll be giving 5 to 0, and we need to pass a third argument where we'll be telling minus 1. Using this we can see here it's going to print in the reverse order, right? This is how exactly we'll be using our condition and control statement. Thank you for watching the video, guys.